muddy, muddy mess out here today.
So we're gonna attach the carryall here and go down and try and collect some sap with hopefully I'll get the tractor stuck.
That's definitely going to be the goal, to not get the tractor stuck. Let's see how that goes, though. I am sinking in everywhere.
All right, we are all attached here. You can see right below me here. It's kind of the swamp I'm dealing with. Gets even worse in the back where all the maples are. Oof. That's fun. So we're gonna see how this goes. If I make it out of here without getting stuck, I will be amazed with myself and this tractor. Took it back here yesterday. Wasn't pretty, let's put it that way. But you can see what I'm heading into. So we're gonna try and get through here. It's not the smartest idea to do. See what this tractor's made of. Alright, that's the worst part of it. So we're gonna park it right here and go ahead and collect from, I got four taps, two over there and two over there, so we'll go ahead and get those and then get this tractor moved. We're definitely getting stuck today. Yep, that is happening. I guess there's no real good time to collect sap in the spring when it's flowing like this. But you'll see why I'm out here when I get this one open. Because we are almost full. Look at this. That is a beautiful sight. And a very annoying dog. Not as much in this one. This is the one with the loose tap, so I'm still losing a lot of it out, but That's pretty much almost 5 gallons from this tree, which is pretty great. All right, so let's go ahead and make our way over to these two guys. Look at this mess. I'd say I got some drainage problems back here. See, this is just all crystal clear as well, so that's really good, really healthy sap. So I'm gonna go set this over by the next tree, and then we will head over there with the tractor and get loaded up again.
Going slow and easy through here, that's for sure.
I'll probably put this in the category of not one of the smartest things I've done today. Oops, just spilt sap, that's not good. Jeez, this one's full. Awesome. In another bucket. The rest of this one. Goodness, another almost full one.
I think after this move, I'm just gonna leave the tractor there and then go on to the other trees on foot. We'll just kind of use this as a base to collect from. So I really don't want to get stuck back here, but not make for a very fun day.
Bucket. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get everything else collected and I will check back in with you. All right, so all in all, I think I got about 26 gallons. I checked the trees in the back and probably got about a gallon from all of those. So not a lot of flow back there.
I've never tapped those, so I didn't know what they could do. So I'm not completely surprised by that. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna strap everything we got here down. And hope for the best getting out of here. Bear with me, first time strapping these in. Just want to make sure I get it right. All right, wish me luck. We are going to go out the same way we came because spot to the left, I know without a doubt I will get stuck in. Turned around here. Chalk this up to not one of the smartest things I've done in a while. But here we go. Getting through that one.
happening is the backhoe's bottoming out. And we're stuck.
Chalk that up to dumb and don't do this at home with your tractor. Tore everything up real good, but now I'm getting stuck. Got it out to high ground, and that's where it is going to stay until this freezes again or dries out, because it's not going back there. Well, I am going to carry the sap the rest of the way up to the porch where it's going to sit until we boil. So basically what we did, and the camera was kind of far away so you can't really see it, but Lauren was in the driver's seat driving and I used the backhoe to kind of move myself out of the way. We tried going forward, that didn't work, so we ended up going in reverse. I went back around where I was collecting sap, went up the way I thought I would get stuck, almost got stuck again, but managed to plow through it there. But you know, this will be the hardest earned sap I ever got for 26 gallons, so half a gallon of sap is what it is. But yeah, if you like my stupidness in this video, or you know, don't like it, which I didn't, hit that dislike button or hit the like button. That's gonna do it for this video. We'll see you next time on the farm where we will not be tractoring because it's too muddy.